Hey YouTube, this is Alexander, and lately I've gotten a few requests to show you all what I have on my OnePlus 2, so that's what we'll be ending the week with. Here's my What's on My Android OnePlus 2 edition. Let's take a look. So the first thing to note here is that I'm using the Google Now launcher and have been since a few days ago. Before that, I was using the OnePlus launcher. But anyway, aside from the leftmost Google Now screen, I've got two home pages. On the first one, we can see a few of my most used apps. So GTasks is an awesome app for keeping track of tasks that you may have, such as homework, school projects, or YouTube videos. What's great about GTasks is that it will automatically pull your Gmail account from your device and sync your task with your Google account, so there's no signing in troubles. It also has these useful color coding options to easily sort your different task labels, and of course features reminders and snoozing. It's an all-around great app that I enjoy using for school and YouTube. Moving on, I have Play Music, which is my music client of choice because it's a good pre-installed app. All access is only $7.99 a month, and I get YouTube benefits from that price, and uploading my own downloaded music is super seamless. Next up, there's Phoenix, which is my Twitter client of choice because of its simplicity and functionality. It features a few different appearance customizations such as theme and accent color, but also syncing and navigation settings, which is a nice touch for the user. Also, the swipeable elements really make it feel intuitive and smooth. Now on my dock, there are some standard apps, and I've recently gone back to Messenger for SMS since Hangouts was causing me some trouble yet again. Now moving on to the second page, we have two rows here. So I've got my Gmail app, of course, for my emails, and Studio, which is especially useful for monitoring analytics of my videos. I can see things like view count, comments, subscribers earned, and more. It's a very useful app for any YouTuber who likes to have this information on the go. Then there's Drive for storing files and creating slides, docs, and sheets, and of course Instagram, which you should follow me on. Down at the bottom on the second row, there's 9GAG, which houses a pretty interesting collection of images, GIFs, and videos. It's something that I enjoy browsing on my spare time. After that, I have Google Plus and Snapchat, which you can add me on, and Pocket Casts. Now, Pocket Casts is my favorite podcast app because of its beautiful UI. It's flowing with material design goodness and features a ton of options. So in the settings, we can set which podcasts are automatically downloaded and when they're auto-downloaded. There's also an option to tweak which podcasts will notify you of a new episode, and there are a few appearance and sync options. Overall, it's not just beauty, but it's also brains, which is awesome. Heading into the app drawer, we can first and foremost see that it is vertically scrolling, and I gotta be honest, I wasn't a huge fan initially, but it's since grown on me and I actually like the vertical scrolling. It's partly due to the nostalgic factor for me since my first Android phone had a vertically scrolling app drawer, but it's also partly convenient because flicking my thumb up and down is much easier than side to side. But enough about that. Inside my app drawer isn't much. I've got the usual pre-installed apps along with a few third-party ones. I have Discover for managing my card and Dropbox for my wallpapers and some APKs. Moving down, I also have Fit, which is what I use to keep track of my steps throughout the day. It's from Google, so it'll plug in with your Google account and sync across all your devices. It's especially handy since I go on nightly walks and I like to know if I've met my goal for the day, and although it may not be 100% accurate, it does give me a decent estimate as to how many steps I've taken. You'll also notice I have GTA San Andreas. Now, I've already beat the game, but I have installed it here to test out performance and warmth on the OnePlus 2 for my full video review, which is coming soon, so you should subscribe if you want to see that. Anyway, there's also Periscope, which is what I use to live stream myself, and a new wallpaper app named Plastexo. So inside Plastexo is a bunch of material design inspired wallpapers, as well as abstract and photography ones. It's a pretty neat collection of wallpapers for those who enjoy this sort of style. Oh, and there's a nice animation when you want to apply a wallpaper that I really enjoy. Pushbullet is what I use for sending photos from my computer to my phone or other devices with Pushbullet installed. It's super convenient, and like GTasks, it will pull your Google account from your device, so there's no need to sign in, and it also features SMS sync, so you can reply to your SMS messages from your computer. It also has notification mirroring so that your app notifications will appear on your desktop. Now there's also a remote desktop to control my computer when I'm away from it, which is handy when I'm not home but I need to check the status of my video upload or publish it. Then of course there's just the last few apps, including Schools First, Speed Test, Wallet, and YouTube. Anyway, that was pretty much it. I hope you all enjoyed it, and if you did, be sure to hit that like button and subscribe down there for more videos from me, including my OnePlus 2 review and Nexus 6P coverage coming later this year. Have a good Friday and a great weekend, and I will catch you in the next one.